It's Friday night, so you know what that means, folks. It's time for another edition of The Final Drive here on DMVStream.com. I'm your host, Jeremy Huber. Another big night in football in the area, in the district, in Maryland, in Virginia. It's all over. We try and get it to you all, get all the scores and everything. Usually we start by running down scores on this show, but today we're going to be breaking the format just a little bit because we're lucky enough to be joined by the head coach of the Northwest Jaguars, victorious tonight over Seneca Valley, 46-6. The Jaguars looking like every bit of their number three ranking in the All-Met Sports poll, and we're lucky enough to be joined by their head coach right now, Mike Neubiser. Mike, congratulations on the big win tonight, and thanks for coming on. Obviously, you had to be pretty happy with your team's performance tonight.
Yes, very happy. Thanks, Jeremy. I love being on the show. Thank you.
I mean, we looked at the score, and 46-6, obviously Seneca Valley was seen as a challenger to you guys, and it seems like your team really stepped up tonight. I assume you're pretty happy with what you got from your guys tonight.
Definitely. I mean, we made some mistakes, but we'll get better. And, Seneca's a good football team, and they have a great program. And I was very happy with the outcome, obviously. We were excited. That's a huge rivalry. And we played for the King's Trophy every year, so winning that is a big deal. Each team, whoever wins the game gets to hold the trophy for the year. And our kids are excited to have it for the year.
And obviously they should be proud of that accomplishment. And let's start right at the beginning, Coach. Obviously, when you're an underdog, you're usually looking to knock off the better team, maybe by a few special teams plays. Well, it seemed like your guys kind of turned that philosophy on the head. Your first score came on a block punt. Can you tell us a little about that play and the guys who pulled it off?
Yes. We kind of created an overload on one side, and Chuck Anya, our outside linebacker, who's a senior team captain, came up through the A-gap and blocked it, and Martin Foray, who's a D1 prospect at corner and outside linebacker, he ended up scooping it up and scored his second touchdown of the year on a return. So it was just a good overall play, and the guys executed exactly how we drew it up.
And did you and your special teams coaches think to yourself this might be something that you guys could get, especially to kind of get that momentum in your favor early on?
We were hoping. Actually, I'm the special teams coach, so I did. I drew it up, and our guys executed it really well. They did a good job. We have a really good senior leadership, you know, and those guys buy into the special teams. We spend a lot of time on it, and they do a good job, and it makes a difference.
Obviously, it did tonight, getting things going. Another guy had it going for you, your tailback, E.J. Lee, by reports about 170 yards tonight, some touchdowns as well. Talk about him and his performance tonight.
Oh, man, he's so tough to tackle. He's not a big guy. Small, but he's really powerful, and he's difficult to tackle in space. And our offensive line does a great job of getting on people, and usually he just kind of hides behind guys, and then just pops out of nowhere and ends up getting, you know, forward progress. A lot. He does a great job, you know, running his feet. He's a great tailback. He actually catches the ball very well in the backfield. Also, tonight he had a great night catching and running the ball.
Now, obviously, your defense had to put out a performance anytime you hold a team to six. What were some of the secrets there on the defensive side of the ball for your squad?
I think overall we have good team speed. You know that's important. We had a good rush off the edge. Martin Frey, who I mentioned earlier, did a good job coming off. And Chuck Anya had an incredible game at outside linebacker. We were able to get stops when we needed them. And the guys filled the roles. Seneca, you know, they were a power running team kind of coming in, and they ran a lot of double tights at us, and our kids did enough to get off the field.
And when you go up against a team like that, obviously they're looking to make it a smash mouth football game. Is there any kind of extra thing when you're talking to your defense during the week, saying, hey, you know, we've got to be ready for a physical battle? If we can match that physicality, we'll come out the winner?
Yes. Seneca's very well coached. They had a couple of different schemes they ran at us, and they actually exposed us a little bit for a while there. They had a long drive to score the touchdown right before the half. Momentum was kind of right there, and they could have almost taken it from us, but our kids responded, and we made a few adjustments at halftime, and we were able to shut them down eventually. But they did a good job, and they have a good running back and a big offensive line, and they do a good job.
Talking to the head coach of the third-ranked Northwest Jaguars, Mike Neubiser, here on The Final Drive on DMVStream.com. Mike, got to ask you, my age, I'm 35 years old, and I remember when I was in high school, Seneca Valley was the team up there. You know, they had so many state championships. Is there still that kind of, a little bit of aura just to say that, you know, going up there and getting a win against Seneca Valley, is that still a special thing for teams, obviously you guys and teams in your area?
100%. They're a well-respected program. They're the only one of the most storied programs in the state, and they've won more state championships than anybody in the state, and they're always going to be looked at as one of those teams. You know, they run a good program. Coach Kim does an amazing job, and they're a young team this year. I'm sure next year that they'll be back and they'll be, you know, in the playoffs and vying for a state championship. And then honestly, this year they have enough talent that they could come back. You know, this is a rough loss for them, but they have a great program. So beating them is no small feat. They're a good program.
A good feather in your cap. Now, Coach, how do you think this one sets up for the rest of the season for you guys? Obviously, you know, you guys have your sights on a state championship, as you always do. But do you think this one kind of puts some momentum, and do you think it kind of gets you going to the back half of your schedule?
It definitely helps. I mean, we do have some really tough competition ahead. I mean, there's a lot of great programs starting this week. We play Gaithersburg, and, they're great program. I actually played at Gaithersburg, so I know the whole coaching staff. Those guys, they do a great job. They have some Division I athletes on their football team, and they're a good football program. And then, you know, down the road, we play some great programs. We got Paint Branch, Clarksburg, Prince Orchard. So we do have a work cut out for us. You know, it's not an easy ride by any means.
And one final one before we let you go, Mike, is there anything that you can see that you'd love to see your team improve on as you go later on in the season?
Yeah, definitely. There's a couple of things. Penalties, we had way too many penalties, for dumb stuff, you know, unsportsmanlike type stuff. We need to clean that up, be more disciplined about that, and then our tackling needs to be a little bit better. No discredit to Seneca Valley's running backs. They're very, very good. Adrian Khalid Platt is an excellent running back. He made our guys miss a lot, so we really need to, work on our tackling also.
Obviously, things to work on always for a program, but a lot of good things right now at Northwest. A big win for them tonight, 46-6 over Seneca Valley. Coach Mike Neubiser, congratulations, and thanks so much for joining the show.
Thanks, Jeremy. Have a good night.
You too. And again, Northwest with a big victory tonight. And really, it was one of those things where you kind of expected them to go ahead and get the win in the game tonight, but maybe not by the outcome that they did. Again, 46-6. Northwest knocks off Seneca Valley, and again, looked every single bit there. Number 3 ranking in the Washington Post poll. EJ Lee, a big night for the Jaguars. Approximately 170 yards on the ground, some touchdowns as well. So he really had it going, as did the whole team, as they get the win. Northwest right now, technically the highest ranked team in Maryland, at least when you talk about the teams in the district, the ones ranked in the All-Met Sports poll. Maybe some teams up in Baltimore, maybe a little bit higher standing, but when it comes to the teams in the DMV, at least the ones we focus on, they're right up there at the top when it comes to football in the high schools. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break. We're going to come right back and start with our usual rundown of your scores. A lot of scores tonight, an upset in the top 5. We'll get you up to date on that as well. I'm Jeremy Huber, and you're listening to The Final Drive on DMVStream.com. Remember, you can interact with the show by tweeting us at DMVStream, and go ahead and hashtag that with DMV Final Drive. That's at DMV Stream, hashtag it with DMV Final Drive. We'll be right back with more of The Final Drive right after this here on DMVStream.com.
Hello, and thank you for viewing this portion of our recent broadcast. This concludes the free viewing experience for this broadcast. If you're interested in viewing the remainder of this broadcast, you can simply click the Add to Cart button below this video where it says Download a Copy. You can also purchase a DVD of this broadcast, which will be viewable on computers and televisions. DMVStream.com is an independently funded project, meaning that your purchases and pledge of support go a long way in helping us to continue to broadcast live sporting events in the DMV. Thanks for stopping by and for your continued support.